Hi everyone, so the camera I got today is the Minolta X300 SLR. Because I already have a bunch of MD glass knocking about, it makes sense for me to get a compatible camera. So I got this X300. It requires two LR44 batteries to function. It's all electric. It's something that I'm not a big fan of with old film cameras. I prefer more mechanical ones. But it was the cheapest Minolta MD camera I found, because I want to do a little bit of night shooting. So what best film to use than this Double Film Cinema 800? It's my last film from my mystery box from Analog Wonderland. I've been told that this film is basically the same as CineStill 800T. So if that's the case, both of these films are repurposed motion picture film, that being Kodak Vision 3 500T. These motion picture films tend to have a layer called ramjet, and this layer is removed so it can be developed using C41 developing. As a result, these films give you halation around bright lights and neon. So I'm not sure why this and CineStill is rated at 800 ISO when the original motion picture stock is rated at 500. Maybe it's something to do with a ramjet removal, or maybe just a marketing gimmick. I don't know. It's that time of the year, it's crimbo time. So as cliche as it sounds, I'll be heading out and shooting some Christmas lights or any neon lighting that I can see. Hopefully I'll get some good images with this film. Let's go and have a look. So I'm in Oxford City, got Christmas markets and all that kind of thing going on. I'll take a few shots around and see what else I can see. I'm just going to take some urban-y pictures with the mist that we got going on here, look. It's very foggy, so it might add a bit of an effect. Yeah, due to this mist, I think I'll get a bit more creative and just take some misty photos. Now the thing is, you're not going to see me take pictures because I've only got one pair of hands and my hands are really cold. So, you know, I have to concentrate on getting that picture taken rather than holding this and then doing this at the same time. So yeah, I think I'll end up with some misty photos. I feel like such a dodgy geezer mooching about the place, looking in people's gardens to see if they've got Christmas lights. It is bloody cold, but I'm nearly done. Thank you. Can you give me just one moment? Just one second, okay? I'll be right back. There you go, that's a lot nicer. Just to get myself into something more comfortable. So, double film cinema. So when I got the scans back, I wasn't too impressed. They looked to me like they were a little bit overexposed by one stop. So the lab I used was AG Photographic, and I've always used them in the past. To be fair to AG, they do state that their setup is more based around the more mainstream films rather than these experimental ones. I could have used a different lab like Analog Wonderland or Silver Pan because they tend to deal with these films a lot more. But because it's Christmas time, it's getting busy, and I needed the scans back as soon as possible, I decided to go with AG because their turnaround is super quick. So, as I said, I can't really fault them. They kind of provided me scans which were more of a baseline. So basically, all the shadows were brought up to try and show the details in the shadows. It's not really ideal for nighttime shooting because when you're out and about shooting nighttime, you don't really see so much shadow detail. Being a movie nut myself, I've seen a lot of films and I've seen a lot of work prints. And the thing to tell you about work prints is that they don't look like the final product. You tend to find that their white balance is slightly off, or they're overexposed or underexposed. You get the idea. When you're shooting motion picture film, it's not a case of like you shoot your film and then it goes straight out to distribution. It has to go through post-processing. I took the scans, put it down one stop, started crushing the blacks, added a little bit of contrast, and the images just improved so much. So the point which I'm trying to say is if you want to get the best of this film, I would say you may have to do a little bit of tweaking after you get your scans. If you were shooting with this film and you just got prints immediately from your developers, you might be a little bit disappointed. But if you treat it like motion picture film and say grade it like motion picture film, then you're going to get better results and you'll be more happy with it. It's not a photo camera film, it's a cinematography film. So what can I say? It's a pretty cool little film actually, and it's nice to have the options. Some people will say these films are trash. I don't think so. I think it's nice to have the option. It has a distinctive look, and I would use it again. I may well use CineStill 800T. I'm interested in getting the 120 format film just to give it a go and see what the results would be on a medium format camera. I like the colours that came out of this film. Very natural, even in night time. That's what it's all about with this film. If you're shooting at night, I'll recommend to do the following just to try and get the best images possible. Try shooting at 500 ISO instead of the 800 ISO on the box here, because the box speed here is a little bit dubious. If your images come back a bit too bright, embrace those blacks. Put the blacks down and you'll see that those colors will pop even more. If you're shooting, you know, lights and neon signs and stuff like that, try to get as much illumination as possible, because I've noticed in my images at least, maybe it's a user error, I don't know, that the images which had a lot of illumination had much less aggressive noise in the image. Whereas the ones where I had, say, like a single lamp would have a lot more noise going on. Because at the end of the day, film loves light, and especially very light sensitive motion picture film like this. There's a reason why, you know, on film sets they have loads of lights everywhere, because film loves light. Speaking of which, some people don't like the halation, but it has its uses, and it's certainly a nice creative thing to have. It's all about that neon, baby. So, yeah, double film cinema, pretty good. And as I said, this Minolta, not a lot to say about it. I got it because I needed a cheap SLR to go with my Minolta glass. Very, very easy to use. I'm just not a big fan of cameras that are electronic. I'm not too sure if there's actually a Minolta MD mount camera that's fully mechanical. If there is, let me know in the comment section below. So yeah. Excuse me.
Has double film cinema been good? Yeah. I think it'll go on my good list. Have you been good? Excellent. I hope you all have a wonderful holiday season and a happy new year. Hope to see you next time. Bye bye for now.